Come a long way, and just the ground rules again, about 20-ish minutes or something like that for your presentation. I think you'll all be very excited to see what they're going to do. The folks right here are the folks who are the jury, but in reality, they're just very excited to be watching. And then the folks in the back are attending as seminar attendees as well. So once you are done, we're going to get into a whole question and answer session. So with that, you guys are up. Okay.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace be upon you.
My name is Hamza, and I'm the architect.
My name is Muhammad, and I'm the environment officer.
My name is Adam, and I'm the community officer.
My name is Muhammad, and I'm the quantity surveyor.
This is our school.
Our community.
Our world.
This is School of Mine.
We've designed a short clip for you to see about our project.
After releasing it into a room temperature, it will turn into a gas. A turbine will be connected to a generator. Due to the force and pressure of the nitrogen, it will turn the turbine to create free energy.
When the gas is released, this acts as a turbine and springs. The two magnets produce a magnetic field. The wire cuts the magnetic field and produces an electric current. This makes free electricity.
At night, when no one else is in school, we release a bit of the electricity to compress the gas into a semi-liquid state. And when released bit by bit into a vacuum flask, it will turn into a full liquid state, so it can be easier then.
At night time, when electricity is cheaper, we will pump the water back to the school lake. Most of the energy required to pump the water back will be from our own secondary energy source. Our secondary energy source is linked to our school's ethos of giving back to the community. Pupils, parents and community members will be allowed to use the gym facilities for free, as the equipment will be connected to generators that will produce energy. Our school will consist of three floors, including the ground floor. The ground floor will have waiting seats, the reception and the visitor's entrance. In addition to this, we will have a vending machine for the visitors to occupy themselves. In the second floor, we will have the STEM. important not to just have classrooms. So we made the cafe, the kitchen, the toilets for children, boys and girls, and for the staff, and an assembly hall. Throughout the middle of the school, we'll be having a lift for disabled people to go to their next lessons, and circling that, we'll have stairs for students to go to their next lessons.
We'll place a man-made hill over our school so it will provide insulation and so we can grow our own fruit and veg. Also, thermochromic glass will ensure that most of the city's infrared radiation is retained, thus reducing our heating bills.
School of Mind is a purpose-built centre for the community, centrally located where flowers grow, fruit grow, and children grow. They blossom, they ripe, and mature to be the best individuals that every society can only dream of having. Our school is located in Blackburn, in the northwest of England, once a weaving capital of the world that united labourers from all over the world, now faces a problem, a community problem. Blackburn is a multi-ethnic town with people of all faith and backgrounds. Through our school, we hope to bring together all these people and eradicate the problem of segregated communities that Blackburn has long suffered with. We want to create a school that will develop a generation of forward-thinking people, people that will transform Blackburn into a new, modern, multicultural and integrated community. We want our school to be a centre for community cohesion. Our school will be located in fields over a coal mine. Land that was once used to generate electricity will once again be used to generate energy, but this time clean, renewable energy. It is in a central location, it will be situated in a central location in Blackburn, allowing easy access by bus, train and cycling, or even walking. The structure of our school is a man-made hill, which will fit in with the natural surroundings. We have designed a building suitable for the community and the environment, a school where up to 1,000 students from all different sections of the Blackburn community will attend. We built our school on top of a coal mine, an area of land that could collapse due to the pressure of any building above it. However, we have put in place a recycled oil rig structure to support our school. With the world becoming more and more populated, making it sustainable has never been more important. Our thinking behind our school has therefore been, how can we use less land? When considering how we power our school, we went down the generic route of wind turbine and solar power, but that was unacceptable for us as it used up too much land. We have thus decided to use a nitrogen power generator and hydroelectric power as our primary energy source, and people as our secondary energy source.
To make our school more eco-friendly and sustainable, we have come up with a number of features. The first being light tunnels. Light tunnels are perfect for bringing natural light into the school to places where it is dark. It will bring light to places such as corridors, bathrooms, washrooms, etc. We are going to be using hydroelectric power. We are going to stabilise our mineshaft using concrete slabs. We are then going to use this space for hydropower. At night, when electricity is cheaper, we are going to pump the water back to our own school lake. Liquid nitrogen is another one of our main sources of energy. Our liquid nitrogen will be contained in a vacuum flask. This is so conduction and convection will not occur. Around the flask there will be a silver lining. This will stop radiation from taking place. Inside the flask there will be three chambers, each with a separate function. When the liquid nitrogen turns into a gas, the force and pressure of the gas will turn a turbine, creating free electricity. Underneath our shoes there will be a turbine. Linked to a turbine there will be a generator. Every step we take, the turbine will spin, creating free electricity. The glass we are going to use is called thermochromic glass. Thermochromic glass adapts to the weather depending on the atmospheric temperature and light. On top the Tauheedul, there'll be a green roof. Green roofs help in a lot of ways. Green roofs create space for parks and gardens. It will also create space for agricultural reasons and will be used for picnics. Using all these features, we are going to have 0% CO2 or any other pollutants. We will not require a single light bulb and will use community spirit as a renewable energy supply.
A core part of our vision is the community, and to create strong links, we will have a community library for use after school hours and on the weekend, giving full access for the students as well as the community. Once we have this, a community cafe will be available, where local farm fruits and vegetables will be used. This will allow us to build links with local farms. They will share their expertise, allowing us to become a self-sustained school for growing our own food on our hilltop. But our hilltop will not only be used for this, but also for stargazing. Language and parenting lessons will be on offer for the community, as well as gym membership. This will be free on the condition that the community provide 1 hour of electricity exercise every week. Our equipment will be plugged into a battery-powered generator. This will promote a healthy lifestyle and give us free electricity. Our school grounds will be used for community festivals. A fab lab for the local people will also be available, and through successful inventions, we hope to gain sponsorships. The school's curriculum will promote real-life learning. Subject teachers will work together towards one school project every 4 weeks, allowing students to see the bigger picture. For this, the school will use many businesses, and the local businesses will benefit from this. In our school, we will have 3 floors. The first floor will have the dining hall, reception hall. The second floor will have the learning STEM, science, technology, engineering and maths. The third floor will have communications and humanities.
So, how big is our school? The size of our school is approximately 7,500 square meters. This, walkways, extra facilities, and our man-made lake will take up approximately 350,000 square meters. The approximate price for our school is $30 million. Although this is higher than traditional schools, we hope to then get back this money by selling back the extra electricity to the national grid. What is the annual rainfall and how will it affect the energy? The annual rainfall for our chosen location, Blackburn, is approximately 300 millimeters. Although this is considered extremely high compared to other countries, we hope to use this to our advantage as it will provide water for our lake, which will then allow us to create hydroelectricity. Our aim is to create successful, confident, blossoming students who shine in the community. To help us do this, we have made our school learning driven by including open space learning environments, push walls on some floors, allowing all the space to be used effectively, workshops instead of typical classrooms, cross-curricular learning, allowing the pupils to always see the bigger picture. All of this contributes to the ethos and the vision of our school, to be the best of the best, to be part of one family,
one school,
one community,
one world.
Thank you very much for supporting me.
We're going to show you the schedule.
Wow. When you graduate.
That was a joke, guys. Well, I don't think anybody can even ask questions like that, but we'll go ahead and try to take a couple.
Let's talk about hydrogen. That's pretty unique. There are hydrogen generators.
Nitrogen.
But it takes energy to liquefy nitrogen, and then you get the energy back out when you go to a gas. How do you reconcile the fact that you're using energy in the process for liquefaction of nitrogen?
Draw a little diagram of how that liquid nitrogen actually works.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, this is the vacuum flask where the liquid nitrogen will be contained in. So this will be chamber 1, chamber 2, and chamber 3. Inside chamber 1, there'll be gas particles. So the liquid nitrogen can actually turn into a gas. The force and pressure of this gas will turn a turbine, creating free electricity. And we want to use this liquid nitrogen again, so we're going to pump the gas back into the third chamber, and we're going to use some of the energy we've already created to compress the gas into a semi-liquid state, and there'll be a latch over here which will open bit by bit, so the liquid nitrogen can actually enter it again, so we actually be using it again and again.
That's it for the question. you obviously astounded everybody. So
yes.
That's
really want to hire you. So.
Yes.
And I heard it's good. I'm sorry. About the process, how did you guys get together to think about this? Was it just your group? How did you come up with the ideas to do this?
We thought of all these ideas by actually seeing professionalists and researched on the computer, and we actually brainstormed and things like that.
In addition to this, we usually meet after school, and we first had a large group, and then we shared ideas, had a bit of fun, and then this is how it all happened. This was created.
How often did you meet? A week.
Right at the beginning, it was once a week for 45 minutes. Later, it started same on Mondays, 45 minutes, and then it was Friday after school for 1 or 2 hours.
You talked about the importance of bringing the Blackburn community together. Can you talk a little bit about how you hope to do that, and are they integrated into the learning process itself?
So the actual building will be centrally located, so it'll be in the middle of Blackburn. So it'll allow easy access by train, bus, or even walking.
We also got extra facilities like stargazing and different extra facilities that people can come in. So the community will come together, you'll create new friends, we'll see new people, and then we'll have different sort of fab labs, we'll have all sorts of different activities that will go on to bring people together to create into one community.
And we're going to, the gym will also be good because people can actually communicate with each other and make friends.
How will you get that message out to the community? How will you let them know that there's all these opportunities?
Well, we'll have sponsorships, so we'll also get the sponsorships to pass the word around as well.
And
we'll
also raise signs to say that all community can actually enter and things like that.
Does your structure respond to the movement of the sun throughout the day, and if so, how?
Yeah, we'll have light tunnels which direct sunlight into the school. Our school will also be south-facing, so we can take as much of the sunlight as we can.
You talk about hydroelectric. Do you have a water source nearby?
Yeah, we're going to have our own school lake. It's going to be man-made, so the water is going to run through underneath into the coal mine, and we're going to pump the water back, so it's just like a cycle.
Follow-up question. Coal mines typically have water that is contaminated with heavy metals. Have you thought about that in your design?
Yeah, so we thought about the methane which is created within the coal mine, and we thought that the water which is actually running through would take the methane out.
Can I just first of all thank you for the presentation? I think it was really superb, and it was great and well thought through, so you did a really good job. You were talking, when you talked to us about the various spaces on the ground floor, the middle floor, and the STEM lab, you described the idea that, I think the words you used were, it would be good to have different types and sizes of spaces in the building, not just traditional classrooms, or I think that's what you were saying. What was your rationale for that, to have those different sort of sizes of spaces and walls that might push? How did that come about, and what are your thoughts on that?
In our, we have push walls, so according to how big our class, how many students we have in a certain class, we can push the walls out. So if we need more space for, say, geography, we can have a box on geography and push the classrooms out. So we have the exact space that we need, and it'd be more open. It won't be crammed into one space, and it won't feel normal. It will be normal, but it won't just feel like any other old school.
Yeah. And that makes things flexible, so you can move around and you have more enjoyable time than you would in a normal classroom.
And I think you're suggesting that will improve your learning and your communication with yourselves and your teachers, yeah?
Well, since you bring the economics all into it, how did you arrive at the estimate of $30 million?
Yeah, so first of all, we thought about how much it cost to actually purchase the land that we need, and then we thought about how much it cost for the construction workers, and then we got into the materials and then the furniture inside, and we also thought about the thermochromic glass and etc.
We also thought about the man-made lake which we have to make, so that also added to the cost, and the land that we have to use to buy.
Talked about the community cafe. Who runs the community cafe? Do you run it?
Yeah, the community runs it as well. It's a bit of both. The school runs it as well as the community.
So the community can actually buy like a stall, so they can sell what they want to sell, and the students can actually take part in selling, so to raise money for charity and things like that as well.
That will also put entrepreneurial skills into practice, because the pupils will be working at the cafe.
At the beginning, when you introduced yourselves, you described your roles. Can you go into a little bit more detail why you picked that role and what those roles do?
We laid everything out, so we set like parts, or the sustainability part, the community part, and we actually went to each part and we thought if we're actually good enough. So we thought like research things, we asked people about things, and it came up to us being the sustainability part.
You talked about project-based learning. Are you currently doing that in your school now, or how did you come up that would be a good place to go with your learning?
We thought it'd be good because in maths we do ratio. But students see it as, what's the point of doing ratio? We don't use it in daily life. But if we took part in a project where we could use ratio, and we could use, say, the geography of like this school as it is, people, the students will see that, yeah, everything is important that we do in school. So they'll concentrate a bit more, first of all, and then they'll know why they're doing everything.
Have you thought of, sorry, I was just thinking about the, you're thinking about going to the outside of the building, the use of the land around us. We talked about the hill, as you call it, the lake. But I'm just thinking, have you had any discussions about access to the outside for learning or for students in your discussions?
We saw that they could actually come on the hill themselves and they could actually, maybe play around, they could actually sit outside and learn with that because iPads are portable.
I
can actually take them outside and learn.
Gentlemen, have you guys thought about enrollment for this building? I believe you said it was 7,000 square meters. Is that what I heard? What do you think about possible student enrollment in this building?
We thought of approximately 1,000 students
for this building. From the very beginning until now, what has been your favorite part of this entire process?
I liked working with professionals and learning what they do, and it gave me skills and helped to develop the skills I've already got as well.
I personally like researching about everything that we need in our school.
I actually like the cross-curricular learning because I enjoy all the subjects, so
I just like going right there.
And a follow-up to that, did you guys have fun doing this?
Yeah.
Were you all friends before you started this?
Yeah.
Well,
we met new people really as well. As new people that came.
Yeah, exactly.
What I like most about your project is its restorative nature. Most of us strive to do as little harm to the earth as possible as we do our buildings. And this project repairs a harm that has been done to the earth by an extractive industry where coal was removed and a sore in the earth has been healed by your project. And I just think that's totally commendable.
See, at the beginning, when coal mines first came around, it was a solution because you got electricity and it became a problem. We're trying to make it a solution again. So we're trying to make it a solution because it was a problem before that.
Well done.
So since you enjoy working with professionals and learning things and doing research, and you are now obviously young professionals yourself, would you help mentor a team next year in your school, maybe?
Yeah. Definitely.
Would you guys do it again?
Yeah. You mentioned people wanted the school to address social issues like segregation. How are you trying to do that? How does this remedy social segregation within your community?
We have a community cafe. This will be run by the community itself. So people who are not doing anything, they'd work there, they'd come and eat there, because the prices would be lower than normal because we grow our own food. So that's already reducing the cost. And because it's cheaper, people would want to go there. And whilst people are going there, they'll start making friends and things like that. We have a free gym as well, free gym membership. I don't know anywhere which gives out free gym membership. So people would take this opportunity, and then along the way, they'll make friends.
Also, our building is centrally located, so it's not just targeting one part of the community, it's targeting all parts.
The roles that you took as individual members, did you enjoy it to the point where you're saying to yourself, I might want to be a quantity surveyor?
Yeah.
I come from Ireland, I appreciate quantity surveyors, I appreciate what they bring to the industry. I think this country needs them more. But is there anything that you came out of that saying, I didn't know a lot about that before I started this project, and I'd like to pursue that as a career?
Yeah, so we chose these roles because we never knew a lot about these roles in the first place. So we thought that if we chose these particular roles, we'd learn more about them, and then that might edge us towards going down that career in the future. So.
Any thoughts, folks? Well,
that was two things, I think, as observations, besides the incredible project. You handled yourselves with great poise. You were very, very mature here, so it's wonderful to see. And the other amazing thing was, I think that you confounded each of us with your ability to answer these questions, where these are adults who do this every day, and you folks, I think, really took us for a ride. So I really appreciate that, and I know everybody here appreciates that. So, gentlemen, thank you so much.
You are wonderful.
So before you turn that off, I want you to come around and look at the model with the projection on it.
And, yeah, and Wayne should get a couple photos of that.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah. The light going on?
Yeah.
See how the furniture looks like it's on the floor?
It's three-dimensional.